Hi, Alex here from Rebelloper.com and welcome back to the channel. Now in this video, I am going to show you how you can create a custom UI text field. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, now why would you like to create a custom text field? We are going to create one because in the previous video I have kind of created a custom one, but it had some insets problem, and I promised you that you would have that inside the GitHub repository if you download it. But I figured I would create a new video around the topic because it is a fairly good idea to do so. So let me just build and run and show you what I mean and what we... This is the last episode's project, so we have created a placeholder for a UI text view, but disregard this. The issue was here. When we created our custom text field, our text was kind of put right on the beginning of our... the border of our text field. So let's just type in here, hello. Okay, and that is what we are going to fix today, and we are going to do it, we're going to create a custom UI text field like so, and it will be typing out like hello. And that is what we are going to start doing right now. So let's just close this and create a brand new Xcode project. So let me just go to file, new project. Let it be a single view application, and I will name this. Okay, let's click on next. Let's create a new folder here, and I will create a Git repository so you can take a look at the final code. As usual, let's close this. Let's open up terminal and type in cd, and let's navigate to the root folder of our project, and let's drag and drop it in there and type in pod in it, and that would create a pod file so we can add our tiny constraints pod to our project. Let's change the platform to iOS 12, type in pod tiny constraints, and again that is because we want to anchor or constrain our views onto our project view. Okay, let's go back to terminal and type in pod install. That will install the dependency. Now it's time to open up our Xcode workspace. Let's go to our custom text field folder and navigate to our root view controller. And I will just right off the bat create the custom text field because you already know how to create a UI text field inside the app. And if you are not familiar with, go ahead and take a look at the previous video. So let's create a new file here. And I will name this custom text field. Okay, let's create it and let's import UI kit and let's create a class. The class should be named custom text field and the super class would be UI text field. Okay, and now let's type in init and super init with frame. Okay, that is pretty straightforward. Now let's wait for the error to appear and let's add our required initializer. Okay, let me just resize this so we may see everything that needs to be added here. Now, what do we want to add here? Now, first of all, we want to create a new initializer and that adds in our insets. So init, and here we want to add our inset and it will be a UI edge insets. Okay, and one last thing we want, okay, before we do that, let's call super init frame, and the frame will be .0. Okay, and that should take care of our error. Okay, great. And let's add our inset here, because we are going to use our UI edge insets outside of our initializer. So now it is complaining that we need to initialize our inset. So let's just do that. Before super init frame 0, type in self dot inset sets. Let's add insets there. And we should add in here equals insets, the one that we are providing with the initializer. Okay, and let's just delete this because we don't really need that now. So now we have our initializer with the insets. Okay, now how would this really take into effect? Well, we need to override two functions. And those two functions are, let me just make this, textrect and edit rect, editing rect. And what we want to return here, return bounds inset by insets. Okay, and do the same for the editing rect too. Okay, so that is it. That is our custom UI text field. But before we dive into checking this out, let me just copy and paste all of what I have added here. And that is the corner radius, the border width, and the border color. Okay, and let me just copy, or maybe even the placeholder for our UI text field. So let's just copy all of this out. Go ahead and take a look at it. Pause the video if you'd like. I'm not going to bother. Again, I am going to show you a cool little trick. We need to delete all of these TF dots. And the way I do this is hold down Alt and just drag your mouse over the area you want to delete, release everything, and hit return. And that will delete everything. That's a cool little trick. Okay, so that is our custom UI text field. Now let's go to our root view controller and let's create our text field. So let's build, hit command B so we may get the auto completion, and let's create our text field here, and it will be a custom text field. And I will add in here a UI edge insets. So UI edge insets, and let the top be 0, left 12, bottom 0, and right 12. Okay, finally, let's import tiny constraints. And let's add our subview and constrain it. So first of all, let's add our view's background color to be dot white. And view dot add subview text field view dot edges to super view excluding, and we are going to exclude the bottom, and we are going to add some insets. The insets are the same as UI edge insets, but here we have convenience methods, so we can just type in top and the value should be 36, add a plus and dot left, and that should be 12, another plus dot right, and 12 again, using safe area true. Okay, and finally, not the view, the text field should have these constraints. And again, the text field should have a height of, say, 40. That should be enough. Okay, now let's build and run, and hopefully we would be able to see everything working. Let's just wait for it, and there you go. It is working like a charm. Now, if you wanted to add in here, let's say, an X or a close button, then I'm just going to type in here, hello there. Here is a nice long text that spans all, and as you can see, across the text field. Now, it stops with the 12 points inset, and it starts with the 12 point inset. But if you wanted to add in here, let's say, a clear button or something like that, then you just really need to change the right inset to, let's say, 36. And finally, a last tip. You don't really want to add every time the insets, so you can just simply add these as the default value for the insets. So I am just going to cut this out, go back to the text field, and add this as the standard initial value. So this without the insets would work as well. So let's hit Command R for one last final time. And there we go, we have our custom UI text field with the right insets at your fingertips. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell. Now it's your turn. What do you think about these custom UI text fields? Would you use them in your app? And if you would, then go ahead and comment down below. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.